when you see these swings, the one on the right you're after, the one on the left you're before, it feels massively different. You're probably got the clubs go outside the line, okay? If we look at your taker now before, your hands sort of pushing out and the club would really whip inside and the club now disappeared behind the sort of with the camera there, right down the frame. Hands are level with your hips there, the club now has really got way on the inside and just disappeared way inside, okay?
Yeah.
You compare that to on the right here. Now this feels like the club's going sort of way out here, someone's staying way outside the line. Okay. Go in there, but still a massive improvement on what you were doing. Okay,
I feel like that.
You go on that side, and again, and this is the thing: real and feel are always two different things. Because I said to you, this one on the left, that is this way, okay, felt to you on the red line like the club was there.
Yeah.
Because you intentionally were not going to swing the club on the blue line.
Yeah.
You're always going to try and go on the red line.
Yeah.
So therefore, that angle between red and blue is the dispersion between real and feel.
Yeah.
Okay. So therefore, when you're now on this blue line here. Okay, if we sort of keep the same sort of dispersion there, between there and there, it feels the club's like this, isn't it? Well, not quite that far, but more that way. So that's what it feels like to you.
Definitely.
Okay, because now you're taking the club a lot further out and away than you're used to. The club now is probably a good, based on that, they're good, almost a couple of feet further out this way.
Yeah.
So it feels as though it's way over here somewhere, which as we can see, it's not. But it just shows when you're in a better position now, the club can now start hinging up on a good angle. The angle of your shaft now is more towards the golf ball. You're swinging nicely on plane there. Top of the backswing. It's a switching across the line, but the club's not as closed now. And the end of your club now is nicely on the butt end of that shaft line there, which is good. So as you come back to golf ball, the club can start coming back down more direct to target.
Yeah.
We can start the golf ball now a lot more in this direction. And in the last, 15 shots you've hit, you haven't hit one that's done that.
No, you haven't.
You had a couple that you did hit that went more sort of that way.
Yeah.
Okay. Most of them have gone this way, a bit to the right. Some have gone obviously really straight there, but nothing has shaped in the air because you're not creating the angle of the club. When the club goes around here, the club's coming in here.
Yeah.
Like a Beckham free kick. Yeah. It's creating that spin.
I knew it was doing it.
Yeah. But as we said, the biggest thing that a lot of good golfers do, they know the club's coming too far inside and they get confused with the club and their hands.
Yeah.
So they're scared of taking the club too far inside, but don't want to take the hands out here. That's going to shank it and it will shank it. So you won't do it, but then I'll keep doing this. And when the club comes down to impact at about here, I'll just hold the club face open just a little bit so the ball sort of starts over there somewhere.
Yeah.
And hope for God it comes like a little draw and we get away with it. But it's risky to play golf at that way. And again, you think you're playing in a medal and you're on the 18th tier or whatever, and you're three over par. You don't want to stand there under pressure trying to hold on the club face. You want to stand there, pick your target down the middle of the fairway and hit it straight to that.
Exactly. Yeah.
So get that club working out in front. Again, the drill-wise, get yourself set up. If that's the angle of your club there at setup, keep your hand there, okay, and then hinge the wrist up to 90.
Yeah.
Hit some shots. Do that probably as like a 8-9-9 wedge warm-up few shots. 50 balls to your first 10 or 15 doing that. Just as like a warm-up loosener so you get the sensation of what that wrist hinge feels like going up and how the hands feel within the swing getting the club a bit more, okay? Then try a few shots perhaps a few practice swings against the wall there. So you sort of put a wall there up against your backside and make a few backswings now, trying to miss that wall, okay? So a few takeaways, missing that wall. On this one here, obviously, we see the club would have gone back. You'd have gone into that wall quite quickly. You'd have hit it there, definitely there. And the club's now level with your hips, so that's very early going into the wall there, okay? So it's getting your angle more upright, but it's the angle of the shaft, the direction in which the club swings on, not you just sort of pushing the hands in or pushing the hands out. Your hands are working back, and that there is a good position with your hands.
Yeah.
It's the shaft here, not there, and that's the key.
Yeah.
Okay, so get that sensation of the club swinging up more, get the ball flight a bit shorter, okay? Does that make sense then,
yeah? Yeah.
Good. Have a couple more then, mate.